We're going to begin the program with another coaching change in the NBA. It is breaking news on SportsCenter this Thursday as Rick Carlisle informed Mavs owner Mark Cuban he will not be returning this season. Carlisle, who won an NBA title a decade ago, had 2 years left on his deal, and the decision comes one day after the team fired longtime GM Donnie Nelson yesterday. We now have 7 head coach openings in the league. Carlisle had been with the team since 2008, tied with Eric Spoelstra for the second longest tenured head coach with a team. He's the all-time winningest coach in Mavericks history. With Carlisle stepping down, 3 of the 5 longest tenured coaches entering this season are no longer the head coaches of those squads. Senior NBA insider Adrian Wojnarowski broke the story earlier this afternoon, joins us now on SportsCenter. Woj, what more can you tell us about why Carlisle is not coming back to the Mavericks?
Kevin, I just think ultimately relationships had been frayed in Dallas. I think Donnie Nelson's departure as general manager left Rick Carlisle in a place where there's a new top basketball executive coming in that you haven't worked with, that you don't know, that you may not know whether you fit with him. And I think for Rick Carlisle at this point in his career, in a marketplace where there's multiple head jobs open, and Rick Carlisle goes out into that marketplace with a championship, that 2011 title with Dallas, it makes him unique out there. And I just think his time and his run in Dallas after 13 years was over. That's a long time to coach anywhere in this day and age.
Woj, you mentioned relationships. That's the key here. How does this decision by Carlisle and yesterday's move with Donnie Nelson affect Luka Doncic's future in Dallas?
I don't think it affects it at all, Kevin. He is in line to sign a $200 million extension once free agency opens. And listen, I think Luka was very fond of Donnie Nelson. You heard him talk about that in that statement in Europe earlier today. But ultimately, he's focused on signing that deal. Now he leaves it to Mark Cuban to go out and find a general manager to hire a head coach. You know, there is an assistant on staff, Jamal Mosley, you know, who's been a top candidate for other head coaching openings. Luka Doncic is very fond of him. I certainly believe he'll be a candidate in this process, but the chance to coach Luka Doncic, there'll be a lot of interest around the league in it. But Mark Cuban told our Tim McMahon that he's going to hire a general manager before he does a coaching search.
Okay, let's talk about action tonight. Kyrie Irving out again for the Nets, but James Harden is available tonight as Milwaukee tries to force a Game 7 back to Brooklyn. What's at stake here for Giannis and head coach Mike Budenholzer and the Bucks tonight heading into Game 6?
Well, obviously, Milwaukee's season is on the line here. And Mike Budenholzer is a coach who knew coming into the season that he had to advance in these playoffs to be able to return as head coach. And certainly with the injuries in Brooklyn and now being down 3-2, you know, I think it's imperative for Budenholzer and this Buck team that they force a Game 7 and don't go out with something of a thud with 2 straight losses. Milwaukee did not offer Budenholzer an extension earlier this season. He's got a year left on his deal. His future with this organization, you know, is very much on the line in this series and in these playoffs.
Yeah, after how they lost in Game 5, you can make the case that tonight's game is the biggest one for Giannis and his head coach in their careers up to date. Woj, thank you very much.
Thanks, Kevin.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.